Hi everyone, happy Sunday. Hope everyone's well. It's been a bit cold, hasn't it? And I know things have been gone backwards again, and we're back in lockdown and all those sad things that have been happening. But it's done for a reason. It's to make us safe. It's to protect everyone there in the world, really. And we're all in this together. So we've just got to pray, and we've got to ask God to guide us through this difficult time. And actually, that's what today's message is going to be about asking God to take away our worries and fears and to bless us and to guide us. So in Romans 10, verse 11 to 12, it says, as the scripture says, anyone who trusts in him will never be disappointed. That scripture says anyone, because there's no difference between those who are Jews and those who are not. The same Lord is the Lord of all and gives many blessings to all who trust in him. So it reminds us that Jesus is our Savior, and for everyone, not just a particular person, not just people who believe in him, not just Jews, not just people who aren't Jews, it's anyone. And we are really lucky that he is our Savior. We can pray to him, he can provide, he is there for us. So it's an activity prayer that we're going to be doing, and it's in Jerusalem. They lived a man named Simeon, and he was a good man, and he followed Jesus. He believed in God. He was a God-fearing man, and he was waiting for the time when God would take away Israel's sorrows, and the Holy Spirit was with him. And this scripture comes from when Mary and Joseph took Jesus to the temple. Because that was one of the commandments. You had to sacrifice, you had to dedicate your firstborn son. And Simeon had said that he wasn't going to die until he met the Messiah. And then, so just like Simeon, we can pray and ask God to take away our sorrows. So Simeon believed and trusted in God, and he believed that he would meet the Messiah, and he did. When Jesus went to the temple, he met the Messiah. And obviously that's Jesus. So what we're going to do is, in Psalms 56 verse 8, it says that God collects and keeps track of our tears. Okay, so you are going to fill up a glass of water. Please be careful, let your adult support you if you need it, but cold water, just fill it over the basin, over the sink. And you are going to think of anything that makes you sad, anything that's made you really disappointed, what you worried about, any concerns. I know we started a new year. We were hoping for a better year, but it still is. It's just the beginning of the year. We're going to get through this. So just like Simeon handed over his sorrows to God, we need to do the same. So anything that made us disappointed, anything that made us sad, anything really that makes us not happy, you are going to slowly pour that glass of water down the drain while you're thinking about all the bad, sad things that make you upset, that make you sad, that all your sorrows, all your concerns, all your worries. You're going to be pouring the glass of water down the drain, and while you watch it go down the drain, you are watching it get washed away by God. So once it's down the drain, it's not your problem anymore. You've handed over your sorrows to God. Okay? And when you finish that, you can say a prayer. So you've washed them away, those sorrows have now been gone, and you don't have to worry about them. I know it's hard when it's easy for someone to say, oh, don't worry about it. But if it's something that's been bugging you, it isn't just easy to wash it away. But that's what we want you to visually see, the water going down the drain, and that's your sorrows getting washed away by God. Okay? And then once you've done that, you're going to spend some time praying to God. And praying to him, to ask him to guide you in this year, let you meet your full God potential, whatever he's got out planned for you, let you reach that. And also, now that your sorrows have been washed away, pray for the world's sorrows. So there's loads of sorrows going on in the world, not just the pandemic, there's poverty, there's war, there's loads of things going on in the world at the minute that is very sad. And even now in Reading, there's sad crimes happening, and it's not nice. It really isn't. So we can spend some time, once our sorrows have been washed away, that God can wash those sorrows away of our community, of the world, of our neighbors, all those people. So you can say a little prayer for them. But the main thing is that you've washed away your sorrows. They've gone down. Make sure, if you if you've filled up one glass and you've poured it down the drain and you're still thinking about your sorrows, fill up another glass and pour those sorrows down the drain until you feel all your sorrows have been washed away by God, because that's what he's there for. And while you're doing it, make sure you've asked God to wash these sorrows away, okay? Because it's easy for us to say, oh yeah, our sorrows got washed away, but we haven't asked God to take them away. So you pour your water down before you start. You can say, God, I'm pouring down my sorrows down the drains for you to wash them away. And then you pour them, thinking about all the sorrows that need to be washed away. Fill up as many glasses as you need. Please be careful. Make sure your parents are with you if you need it. It's just cold water, nothing hot. And just be careful you don't spill it everywhere. Okay? And then the next bit you're going to do is you are going to, I'm going to put a picture at the end. So in the story of Simeon meeting Mary and Joseph in the temple, one of the commandments, so as like I said before, one of the commandments was to bring it, so you dedicate your firstborn male, but then you had to bring a sacrifice. And the sacrifice that was, it was a pair of doves or pigeons. So your activity today is going to be, because God is our savior and we follow the commandments and he's washed away our sorrows. So we are going to make our own origami. If you don't know what origami is, it's like where you fold pieces of paper into a shape. So you can decorate the shape if you want to, but we're going to make our own origami dove or pigeon, because a dove is a symbol of peace and reminds us of God's promise. Okay, so if you want to, you could add your own prayer to the origami. It's up to you. But the reason why we're doing this is because our sins have been washed away, but this activity is about our sorrows. So our sorrows have been washed away, our sadness has been washed away down the drain. We're praying to ask God what he wants to guide us in, what he wants to lead us in, and we are going to make a sign of peace and a sign of God's promise. So loads of times there's doves mentioned in the Bible, and it's a symbol of peace and God's promise. So at the end of this video, I haven't made one, but at the end of this video, there is a step-by-step way to make the origami. So you're going to have to pause the video, and it's just one picture, and you can have a look. If you can't do that, so I tried to do it and it worked out, but there's little things that you're going to make sure you fold the paper in the correct way. You just need one A4 piece of paper, okay? And it would be better if it's a square. So I know A4 pieces of paper are rectangles, so what you have to do is you have to fold, ask your parents to help you, but you fold the paper from corner to where it meets the next corner and then chop off that little extra bit, so when you open it, it's a square. Okay, so that's what you're doing. If you know how to make those, I don't know what you call them, but those little shapes that move like that in school and you've got the numbers and the different things, that's the same starting size we need for our dove or origami. Okay, so you fold it. It's got the instructions on the picture. I'll put it at the end of this video. Pause it so you can watch it. If you're struggling to understand these, just watch a quick YouTube video of how to make an origami dove. And it will give you a step-by-step tutorial on there. And you can make it. But make sure you decorate it if you want to. You can write a prayer inside it. And that is your symbol to show that God's washed away our sorrows. And we're living on his promise. Everything's going to be okay. He's there for us. He's taken our worries away. And he is there to bless us. And we've just got to pray and ask him. And remember to, once you've washed away your sorrows, let's pray for the world's sorrows too. I hope you have an amazing week. Some of us might be going to school. Some of us aren't. But whatever you are doing, have a great week. And I will see you soon. Bye.